a pair of sandhill cranes flying low above the cornfields outside our town. Sandhills, for many of us here in Wisconsin, are one of the first signs of spring. We watch for them in the skies, we listen for their calls, and every year their return reminds us that even after the most difficult winters, new life is stirring and new beginnings are underway. And all of us have come together today, all 62,000 of us, not so much to mourn what happened right here a year ago, but to celebrate what happened next and to gather our strength for what's ahead. Change is in the air. I can feel it. Can you? This past year, Governor Walker and Scott Fitzgerald and certain other people who we pay to work for us in the Capitol have used their power to try to undermine some of our state's best traditions. Bullshit! Traditions of open government, civility, and a bipartisan commitment to progress. A year ago last night, Scott Fitzgerald convened a meeting in the Capitol in the dark of night, after normal business hours, without giving even 2 hours' notice as required by law. Others used their power to lock us out of the Capitol and shut us out of the political process. They broke the law that night, but they didn't break our spirit, they only strengthened our resolve. We said, this isn't the Wisconsin way, and we won't take this lying down. And this winter, we rose up. In the cities and the small towns and the farms, and we worked patiently, persistently, peacefully, and through our hard work, we've made them answer for what they've done. And the beauty of that work, especially for those of us out in the small towns and in the countryside, is that it's shown us that we aren't alone. It's shown us that people all over this state share our concerns. And these aren't Democrats' issues or Republicans' issues. They're the concerns of ordinary people who want a decent life for themselves and those who they love. They want to feel secure in their jobs. They want access to health care. They want good schools for all our kids. And most of all, they want their voices to be heard. A year ago, the powers that be refused to hear us, but I think they can hear us now. Yeah! We've come here today in the spirit of new possibilities, the spirit of cooperation, the spirit of love, love for our families, for our communities, and for this beautiful state that we call home. We cherish the rights that our mothers and our fathers and our grandparents fought for. Women's rights. Workers' rights. Voting rights. We love our clean water. We love our rich farmland and our forests. We love Wisconsin's proud tradition of open, honest government. This time last year, we were heartbroken at the attack on the things we hold dear. But a year later, we're back at the Capitol. And do you know what I'm holding in my hand right now? This is Scott Fitzgerald's pink slip. Thank you. get the idea. It's a memo from the Government Accountability Board that was released yesterday afternoon. It proves what I've been saying for the last 2 months. Independents, Democrats, Republicans worked together and did what many believed could not be done. We gathered thousands more signatures than required to recall Senate Majority Leader Scott McCain. And I'm not just talking about the weather. I'm talking about an awakening all across Wisconsin. A renewed sense that all of us matter. All of us have a voice. And by working together, we can bring our state back to its best traditions. Thank you, and on Wisconsin.